All right, so we are now at page 9, where we're starting function operations. So just like all your algebraic operations, function operations work the same, except now they're being done on actual functions. So you have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and the newer one that you have not done, I'm sure, is composite. Composite is just like the rule of substitution. However, I don't think you did substitution before we went on our dramatic COVID break. So I'm gonna pick a problem that's not on your packet at first. And then we'll do the first one on your packet, and then I'll let you practice. So here, functions must always be written in function form. Okay, so addition. It can be written f plus h of x. It can be written f of x plus h of x. This is called function notation. So sometimes on your quiz, I throw a little vocabulary at the bottom, right? And tell you to write in your own words and or give an example. Okay, this is called function notation. It's when you write it as a function of. So you always read it as f of x, g of x. This is f plus h of x. This is f of x plus g of x. Okay, so you read functions of. So then I just take my f function and I add my h function. And addition is the same thing as counting. Keep that in mind whenever you're doing anything with addition. It just means counting. I like to put them in order. What property is that? Moving things around, putting them in order. What property is that? Oh, I don't think I've seen you in the back when I took attendance. Remind me to fix your attendance. Nobody remembers the properties? What property is that when you move things around? No one. Commutative property. Commute means to move, so commutative property. Another vocabulary word, right? Commutative property. It just means to move things around, to change the order. And now I simply count the things that are alike. So I have 2x, I add 3x, I add three of them, and I have 5 kids. I have 12, I'm making 7, and I have 5. You always have to use your function notation, so you can't just leave it like that. I've seen a lot of people giving their answers without the function notation on their homework. That's addition. Questions on addition? Hopefully that's something that we're all pretty familiar with. Okay. Subtraction. Also the same property as counting. Subtraction is still counting. It's just counting them backwards, taking things away. We're going to use the same functions. So, however, when you do subtraction, you want to make sure you use parentheses when you subtract your second function. Again, whenever there's a negative, it's best to control the negatives or keep track of the negatives when there are parentheses. So you want to subtract the entire function. And when you subtract, it means changing the signs. So, I have 2x plus 12. I'm going to take this subtraction sign and give it to everything in here. So instead, this is going to be a negative 3x, and this is going to be a positive 7. So what you did is you distributed this negative, or simply changed the sign of everything in that second function. And I'm going to use the community property again. So if I have 2x and I take away 3 of them, I now have negative 1. Questions on subtraction. The biggest mistake that most people make is changing both the signs. Multiplication. When you multiply, I always relate it when it's just two things to DNA. And so what I mean by the DNA, right? If you think of it, right, like this is my mom, and this is my dad, and this is me, and this is my sister. Your mom has to give the DNA to both me and my sister, and my dad has to give his DNA to both me and my sister. A lot of people forget that everything has to be multiplied together. So think of it as DNA. Mom doesn't just give her DNA to me, and dad doesn't just give her his DNA to my sister. My mom and my dad give DNA to both me and my sister. That's what you want to keep in mind when you're doing these kind of distributive properties. So, I'm going to take my mom, and I'm going to multiply to me. I'm going to take my mom, and I'm going to multiply to my sister. I'm going to take my dad, and I'm going to multiply to me. And I'm going to take my dad, and I'm going to multiply to my sister. And then I'm going to combine them. So, 2x times 3x. Does anybody know what happens when you do x times x? Combined by terms only happens with adding and subtracting. What happens when you multiply? Do you guys do any rules of exponents last year? It becomes x squared, okay?
So I'm just saying, well, x times x becomes x squared. What do you think x times x squared becomes?
What happens when you do x times x squared? X cubed. Okay? So when you're multiplying them, the exponents add, not the actual x. So here I have 2 times 3, which is 6, and x times x, which is x squared. Here I have 2 times negative 7, which is negative 14. And then x doesn't multiply to anything, so it stays the same. 12 times 3, which is 36. I have 1x. And then 12 times negative 7 is negative 84. And now, I'm going to simplify by combining my like terms. Questions?
Yes.
Say one more time. No. So something squared. Squared is its own term. Remember when we were doing domain and the equation that was squared was called a quadratic? Right? So squared is a quadratic term. X by itself is a linear term. And the number with no variable is called a what? That's what it's C. I know you know this one. No variable at the end of equation?
No.
A constant? Please somebody go, oh, I know that. Huh? No, so a constant is the number without the variable. It's the number that doesn't vary. Okay? So the quadratic term, or the thing with the x squared, only gets added to something else with an x squared. The linear term, or the thing with just an x, only gets added to something with an x, another linear term. Constants only get added with constants, or numbers without variables. Okay? Questions on multiplication? Division. Like I said before, we're not really going to divide.
I'm going to show it to you, but it comes up in one of our units.
We have a whole entire unit dedicated to division. So I'm not going to do necessarily division right now. I'm just going to show it to you. Then if you could simplify, you could simplify. This one you cannot simplify, so technically you just leave it like this anyway. So division is simply written as a fraction with an equation over an equation. If it can be simplified, you simplify it. If it can't, you don't. I am not requiring you to simplify it right now. So if you have a division problem up until now, all you're doing is simply writing it over the fraction. That's it. The last one that is not on your page 9, but I do want you to still do it with page 9, is composite function. So, when you composite, right, it's just substitution. It means you take one entire function and you put it inside another function. It's also written with an open dot. Don't compare it to the closed dot, because the closed dot means multiplication. So composite function is when you take an entire function and you put it inside another function. And it's written with an open dot, not a closed dot. Those are two different things. So, my function, f of x, is fx plus 12. However, I want to take my h function, and I want to put it inside. So now, instead of this x, right, because it's usually f of x, I'm going to put the entire h inside. I'm going to rewrite my function. You know what?
I'm not going to take that step.
Now I want h of x to be inside. And so now I'm going to rewrite it. H of x is 3x minus 7.
Anybody have a question yet? Okay. So now I'm going to simplify.
Parentheses mean what operation?
I hear it.
Kind of.
Multiply. So now I'm just going to multiply. 2 times 3 is 6, keep my x. 2 times negative 7 is negative 14. I don't multiply that 12 because it's not in the parentheses. And now I just combine my terms. So my f of h of x is equal to 6x minus 2. And I'm going to read that function notation again. That's f of h of x. So, what I want you to do right now, before I let you practice at home, is I want you to now do h of x. So I want you to take the h function, and I want you to put that inside of it. The opposite of what we just did. Ready, set, go. You ready?
Maybe.
Everybody got an answer? Yes? No? Need another minute? Hopefully everybody tries on their own.
So if I take each, then I put in my left.
Now, you do not have to do every step out, right? So like this step and this step is me writing it out so you understand it. If you skip right to here, I'm fine with that. However, don't skip right to here every time and mess up. So if you're still not understanding completely, write it all up. If you feel like you kind of understand the concept, then you can skip right to this step. So, with every one of the function operations, you're not getting a number. Usually when you did operations, when you added two things or subtracted two things, you got a little number, right? When you do function operations, you're always going to get, so your solution is always going to be another function. Okay? If I was to go evaluate this, which eventually that's what we're gonna do, right? Then you'll get a number, most likely. However, if you are simply putting another function in another function, you're gonna get out a function. On Albert, I think it was question 3 on one of the problems, they had a function and they said evaluate it for like x or b or something like that. I don't remember exactly what it was, but it was something funky like that. What that was a composite function. I did not expect that to be on regular evaluation when I assigned an assignment on Albert. Again, it's really new to me. So yeah, whenever there's stuff like that, I'm gonna say, go ahead and wing it and try, but I'm never gonna count that, okay? Questions? Okay, so there are 5 problems of composite functions, all right? We started talking about the fraction one last class. So that's problem A. B has a quadratic term, an x squared. Remember, you can't combine x squared and x, so be cautious of that. C, C is an interesting problem. I'm gonna say don't do C. Yeah, don't do C. I feel like it's gonna make your head spin. And I'll show that to you. We can do that one together another time. F cubed. So F has something cubed. When you do something cubed and squared, they cannot combine.
However, something cubed times something squared is gonna be what? X to the what?
Somebody said it. The
fifth, right?
So, you cannot combine them, you can't count them, but you can multiply them. Okay. So, practice on your own. If you have questions,